years ago, the idea of Donald Trump running for president seemed far-fetched. Here's what comedian Seth Meyers, who at the time was the head writer for Saturday Night Live and host of Weekend Update, said at the White House Correspondents' Dinner back in 2011.
Donald Trump has been saying that he will run for president as a Republican, which is surprising since I just assumed he was running as a joke.
No joke. Fast forward now to 2016. Meyers is back in the nation's capital this week hosting Late Night with Seth Meyers just in time for the presidential election season. We spoke on Friday before the infamous Trump tape was leaked. Let me bring in my friend Seth Meyers. He's the host of Late Night with Seth Meyers on the National Broadcasting Corporation. Thanks for joining me. It's great to have you here.
It's great to be on the lead.
So you are doing a whole week of shows in D.C. Why?
We had always wanted to take our show on the road. I'd always liked when other late night shows had gone on the road.
And Letterman did that a lot.
Letterman, Conan, sort of famously would go to places like Chicago and San Francisco, and we just wanted to try to pick a place that we thought would fit with the DNA of our show, and DC made a lot of sense, especially right now.
Vanity Fair calls you the heir to Jon Stewart.
What?
Yes, quote, with a lengthy examination of the recent congressional circus around defunding Planned Parenthood, Meyers took a step towards being one of the more political hosts in late night. If you're looking for a daily replacement for your Jon Stewart fix, Seth Meyers might be your man. Do you see yourself as a political late night host?
I do consider our show probably a little bit more political than the ones that have been in that time slot before it, yeah.
You have a segment on your show called A Closer Look. It's basically a 10-minute takedown of something, often Donald Trump.
Well, yeah. When it started, we kind of saw it as an explainer with jokes. I think that was what was the jumping off point of A Closer Look. But it has turned into the Donald Trump segment of the show. Probably more than we expected, but and we do other stuff, but in the 24 hours so much, that more than we thought we would.
You know, Willie Sutton was once asked, famous bank robber, why do you rob banks? He says, that's where the money is. Is that just where the jokes are, or do you also see it as a calling to take him down in a way?
That's definitely where the jokes are. With that said, this is important right now. The election is what we would be talking about anyway, but so we do think it's important, but I don't think we would do it as much if there weren't this many jokes.
There is a big debate going on in the world of comedy right now. It puts you in something of an awkward position because you are a former head writer for SNL, mm-hmm. and also you follow Jimmy Fallon, and he's been criticized for being too soft on Donald Trump. But Samantha Bee, obviously, she does a show called Full Frontal on TBS, and here's an excerpt of what she had to say recently.
NBC did sever ties with Trump after he called Mexicans rapists. If by severing ties you mean inviting him on their flagship comedy programs to show millions of Americans what a fun guy he is.
Why are you hosting Saturday Night Live? Why?
I don't know. I guess because ratings matter more than brown people?
All right. I know, and this is not a nice thing, because we're kind of friends, and this is not a nice thing for me to do, because I'm putting you in a very awkward position.
I'll be fine.
NBC is where you work, and SNL is where you come from, and Jimmy Fallon's the show before yours. But you obviously, if one had to delineate, you're obviously more on the Samantha Bee side of things in what you do, not in your stated views on SNL normalizing Donald Trump.
Well, I think, you know, I have a lot of respect with how Samantha does comedy about politics, and we also do comedy about politics, so I would say we're similar in that way.
Do you think that there is an obligation that comedians have to not normalize a monster, in her view? Or do you think there's room for everyone to do whatever they do? And like Fallon does a very different show than you do.
I think that is the best possible outcome for comedy, is if there are a lot of people doing it a lot of different ways. And I do think you want to have as many different shows as possible, because I understand, it doesn't make me super happy, but I understand that with what I do every night, I am alienating part of the audience. I don't necessarily blame them for that, but I also like the fact that for people who come home after a hard day's work who want to watch a late night television show, that a lot of them don't want to hear about politics, and I'm glad there are other places for them to go.
That's interesting that you're potentially alienating some of the audience. How much of it is about, I just got to be true to myself, I got to be able to look Ash, your new son, in the eye when he's old? I know you know who he is. I'm saying they might not know who he is.
Okay, good.
But I need to be able to look Ash in the eye versus, this is a game of addition, not subtraction kind of thing.
I just think we all have to do the show that's truest to us, and I feel like audiences have a real sense of what is authentic and what is inauthentic. I am very much looking forward to however this election breaks. I think we will talk about politics less come December, come January, come February. I think that will be fun for my writing staff to have that period of reinvention. But I do think this election is really important, and I care about politics a great deal, so it just made sense, and it has been authentic to what we want to do, to do what we've been doing.
Thanks for being here. We really appreciate it.
Thanks, Dave.
Seth Meyers, thank you so much. And you can watch Seth Meyers tonight at 12:30 a.m. You might recognize one of the guests. Coming up, he's the mustachioed fellow with a disposable camera who stole the debate and stole our hearts. Believe me, you're not the first one to think about being him for Halloween. How Ken Bone won the second presidential debate. Coming up.